Can you tell us just a little bit, first of all, about your role in The Seasoning House?
I play this character called Victor. He's a Bosnian war criminal, basically, on the run. And the way he's keeping himself in the shadows is he runs this house, and it's basically the sex slave trade industry. All these young girls, whenever these villages get brutalized and the girls get kidnapped, the military bring them in to me. I pay them, they bring these girls in, I get them put on heroin and smacked up, and then all the guys come in and use them for money. And it's basically not a rape camp, but you could say that, but it's a very brutal brothel, really, yeah. So, not very nice.
Clearly, I think the most shocking part is that the film is based, to some extent at least, on real-life events. Yeah, do you think that adds an extra dimension to this kind of horror?
I hope so, but not in a titillating way, and I stress that, because that was the one thing that we were very adamant about. When Sean and I first went to the script meeting and we sat together and we said, it's the one thing that we were really adamant about, that we didn't want this subject matter being sort of cheated into some cheap titillation and thrills, like vicarious thrills for people, because it's something that is going on out there, you know, and I've studied it a lot, and, you know, looking at the Helen Bamber Institute and the things that she's trying to do to stop all this going on, it goes on in this country. I mean, it's pretty awful. And it's weird. There seems to be some weird zeitgeist about it at the moment as well, because Silent Witness the other night I happened to watch, and that was all about a similar thing about kids, these young Indian lads, getting these young girls on drugs and getting them locked up in houses and everything. So it was like really weird watching that, like 2 or 3 days before coming here to this. So very strange, yeah.
I think clearly the film's going to have an impact on audiences. Did it affect you emotionally being involved in the production?
Well, I hope it has an impact on audiences in the right way. Did it affect me? What, just playing the role? No, that's what I do. It's your homework. That's what you study to do. That's what I do. That's what I study, the character. You get in depth with it. You go for it. And you've got to love what you do. So, you know, those moments when it seems like you're loving the character that you're playing, well, you are. And you're getting involved in that, but you leave it behind. You go home, you leave it behind. So it's just it's a character. This life is out there, and it has to be portrayed, so someone has to do it. So, yeah, this time it was me.
See, we're here at Fright Fest celebrating the horror genre. Yeah. Why do you think people love it so much, and what do you think they get from it that they maybe don't from rom-com, sci-fi?
I think there's a lot of films that are very edgy, and obviously there's a massive horror fan base with Fright Fest. And it's kind of ironic, because even though there are a lot of horrible things that happen in The Seasoning House, I personally wouldn't class it as a horror movie as such. But I would probably describe it more harrowing than horror. So But I think what a fantastic turnout! I mean, a Thursday evening in the middle of the summer holidays when most people are away, I think it's brilliant, fantastic.
Before we let you go, what are you working on at the moment? Is there anything else coming up for you at the moment?
No, nothing. Paul and I in talks about another movie. And that's it at the moment. So I'm having a little downtime, which is great. So it's good.
You mentioned Paul obviously making his feature debut with this one. Can you talk a little bit about how he was to work with as a first-time director?
Oh, he's great. It took to it like a duck to water. I mean, he knows the game. He's been on enough good films and enough bad films to know how to do it properly. And he was organized and prepped. And that comes from him being very specific visually in his SFX makeup work. He's a great guy. And look, he's a great long-standing friend. I've known him for 16, 17 years. So you don't meet guys and you stay friends in a business like this for that length of time very often. So it was great. And he just lets me do my thing. And that's great. You know, just roll the camera. Let's go. That's what I like.